This is Spectrum West. I'm Al Ross. Thanks for joining us here on WPR. Let's move on. Sam Robertson is an Eau Claire guy now living in Minneapolis. That happens fairly often when someone feels like spreading their wings. He's an artist, customary fare on this program. But Sam Robertson had a vision a few years ago. He decided to illustrate the Bible's Old Testament. Paint scenes to aid the process of reading and understanding this ancient volume, except these over 250 paintings probably aren't what you'd expect, and he might not have predicted 7 years of work. Well, now seeing is believing, and you'll have to do that on your own, but we can introduce him through a conversation, which I enjoyed with him earlier this week. So this project... 7 years, man. I mean, the universe was created in 7 days.
Right.
Is there anything else like this? I mean, is there legitimate art done? Not that yours isn't legitimate. For either version of the Bible, old or new?
Yeah, I mean, people have done similar things, like just the book of Genesis. Other people have done it. But nothing like this that I can tell. This is kind of unique, even though it's been painted or interpreted visually so many times before, mm-hmm. especially in the old days. Yeah.
You'll probably notice from some of my questions that I'm not very attuned to the Bible. I was raised as a good little Catholic kid. Catholics, the Bible is kind of just there.
Yep, it's decorative. I went to Catholic school until sixth grade. I don't remember very much from it at all. I'm not a religious person right now either.
7 years, if you do the math, is about 2,555 days, and you have 257 paintings. That's roughly one every 10 days. Is that kind of how you did it?
That's crazy to think about. Yeah, well, I took 1 year off, so there was actually 6 years of painting.
Ah.
But in those other years, yeah, sometimes it would flow faster, and sometimes there would be like life events and things that would keep me from going, so it wasn't like wasn't steady, I should say. Just something I kept coming back to.
So you took a year off. That kind of morphs into a curiosity that, you know, during those 7 years or now six, I was very, very curious as to how often you became frustrated and said, what am I doing here? And how many times did you almost quit? And be honest.
I don't know if I ever actually almost quit during the last like 30 paintings or something like that. Mm-hmm. I kind of was like, should I still be doing this? It seems like there's maybe more important things to do or something. yeah. But then that was like kind of brief. And I feel like it was broken up into so many segments and like books of the Bible. And like I had shows throughout it and mm-hmm. little things just kind of kept me going. Initially, I thought it was going to be a 1 year project and then it just kept going, kept going.
Knowing what I know about religion and the varying degrees of fervor out there, I'm going to surmise that some are going to find your interpretations blasphemous, simply because some folks don't believe religion should be tampered with. Have you run into any of that yet?
A few times. Mostly, it might just mean that I don't talk or show this to enough of a variety of people yet, because I'm kind of wondering if down the pipeline there'll be more resistance to it. But so far people have been pretty open to it and either indifferent or really into it or somewhere between, but there hasn't been too many people who have to my face said that they think that it's blasphemous and that kind of thing. But I'm open to that. I'm open to whatever people think.
Well, you must be, because you're planning on selling this thing door to door. I can't help but to wonder if you're prepared for that, because Girl Scouts don't even go door to door selling cookies anymore. You probably need to be prepared to either have the door slam shut or spend a lot of time with each person.
Yeah, I can say with honesty that I have tried it. I did it in Minneapolis and St. Paul for about an hour total and knocked on maybe 30 doors. And only three people actually opened their door. It was a quick no. I don't want it. Not interested. I'm talking with my friend who is a salesman, and we're figuring out approaches, mm-hmm. how to get a chance to even talk to them.
This is a weird word to use, but you're hell-bent on selling it door-to-door?
Yeah, that's how I'm going to start. I'm not sure how the project will evolve. I'm going to make it into a podcast called Birth of a Salesman. Yeah, I'm having ideas for how it can morph. It's possible that it would kind of be stale after a few episodes of it just being door to door unless I can weave together more interesting elements, which I am working on
Yeah.
currently.
Enjoying a conversation with Sam Robertson. His book is The Illustrated Old Testament, and it's something you may have never seen before and probably won't forget. I read a lot of stuff and watched some videos. Weird is a word that stands out in a description of the paintings that I read. Is that fair? Are they weird,
Yeah,
these
they're
things?
weird. They're
Intentionally
weird.
so?
Yeah, I just kind of took the subject matter and things that I'm interested in and put it into this book. So I was drawing kind of weird stuff beforehand, and this project didn't change it. So it probably even made it weirder how my paintings were matched with the words. So yeah, definitely I would go with weird.
I mean, there's good weird and bad weird. These are good
Oh yeah,
weird.
thank you.
You're going to go on a book tour, and it includes some big towns, including your hometown, Eau Claire. What kinds of locations are you going to be making a presentation at?
Well, there'll be three Wisconsin ones. This is Wisconsin Public Radio, so I should probably
You should.
tell about those ones first. The Madison show will be on June 5th, this Sunday, like in a few days, at a place called Art Lit Lab. It's short for Art and Literature Laboratory. I'll be joined by four poets whose work reinterprets ancient religious figures and stories. Then Friday in Milwaukee, June 10th, 9 to 11:30 p.m., we'll be at Company Brewing. That's a brewery, and there'll be three bands at that one. And then the Eau Claire show is on Saturday, June 11th, and that's at the Volume One local store. I'll be joined by two musicians there, Josh Ingersoll and Matt Vold. Those are the Wisconsin ones.
You're in Minneapolis, you're in Chicago, you're in Hamtramck, Michigan, which is near Detroit, Buchanan, Michigan, near South Bend, Indiana.
Yep, seven places in 8 days. Another Wisconsin item, the Oxbow Hotel bought a copy for each of its 30 hotel rooms. And I'll be dropping those off on June 11th on my tour. I just wanted to give a shout out to them because that's a brave and bold thing to acquire for their hotel rooms,
It
just like in the
is.
Gideon tradition.
There's this wonderful video that I encourage people to watch in which you talk about the production of this volume, The Illustrated Old Testament. And you, in one sentence, use the term human nature, and then right after it, you use the term human appetite. That is a wonderful term, a human appetite. That could be the biggest reason for a lot of things we do, is we have an appetite.
Yep, I would agree. Consumers through and through, in some sense.
Tell me about your hobby of clipping things. I was picturing you as a coupon guy after that,
Oh,
probably.
sure.
You clip things for inspiration. You see things in magazines and newspapers and all over, and you clip them and you stick them into a binder, and they are just photographs of things, and it gives you what?
Yeah, well, I like your idea to start clipping coupons too, because that would be a great way. People have saved for generations, so
Well, you'll be
I'll
good at it.
consider that. Yeah, I got a lot of practice with the scissors.
I noticed you were good with that.
Never been complimented on my scissors work before, but thank you
You're
for
welcome.
that. Yeah, it's like a place I start often with, like, I don't know what to paint. Then I'll look through this. Pictures could be just a landscape or pictures of just people doing things that I find in tourism catalogs, or just like a super wide variety of things, like hunting, fishing, outdoors kind of stuff. I can kind of just like meditate on it while I'm got an idea in my head, flipping through the pages, and then connections will start to form, and then I'll kind of dig into that and see where it leads.
The book is The Illustrated Old Testament. I wager you've never seen anything like it. 520 pages worth, and it's really interesting and creative stuff. I also encourage you to go to MrRobertson.com. That sounds kind of formal. I think that's just for fun. He doesn't care if you call him Mr. Robertson or not. I think Sam is pretty good, yeah?
Oh yeah, it's adequate. And then Mister is spelled out for the website, so
Yes.
MISTER
Yes,
Robertson.
yeah. And you'll spend some time there, as I did. Sam, I admire your courage. I think it took and takes courage to take this all the way. All the way includes plans you have. Good luck with the distribution phase. We're going to keep our eyes on your work.
Thank you.
Take it easy.
You do.
See
Thanks,
ya.
Al.
The publishing website is 1111, that's 1111, press.com/Old Testament. That's another way to get the book if you can't attend one of his presentations or if you closed your front door before realizing it was Sam. Pablo, Season 5, next on Spectrum West.